Fine. One small thing that was ignored earlier is change in density with the temperature. Suppose you have, let's say, a liquid of volume V. Okay, you increase the temperature. Okay, will its mass change? Will its volume change?
Yes.
So will its density change?
Yes.
It should change, right? So how density will vary? That's what the next topic is, right? Write down variation of density. So density is nothing but mass divided by volume. Okay, original density, let's say, is rho naught, which is m naught by v naught. Okay, now if you increase the temperature, all right, the density should be equal to mass remains same, m naught, and volume becomes v naught 1 plus gamma delta t. Okay, this is equal to m naught by v naught times 1 plus gamma delta t raised to power minus 1. Okay, do you remember binomial approximation? Remember, binomial approximation goes like this: 1 plus x raised to power y is approximately equal to 1 plus xy if mod of x is very less than 1, as in it's like 0.00001. Getting it? So similarly here, if you use binomial expansion, binomial approximation, m naught by v naught is rho naught. So this is rho naught 1 minus gamma delta t. Fine, same volumetric expansion coefficient is coming, but density is original density into 1 minus gamma delta t. See, here y is minus 1, comes inside.
So shouldn't that be 1 minus x?
No, here y can be anything. No, y can be anything. Y can be negative also. We don't know. So if y is negative, it will be negative. Any doubts here? No? Let's quickly do a numerical on this. Then we'll proceed to the next property. A solid floats in a liquid at 20 degrees Celsius. Fine. With 75% of it immersed in the liquid. So 75% is inside. Alright? When the liquid is heated to 100 degrees Celsius, liquid's temperature goes to 100 degrees Celsius. Fine. When this happens, the same solid floats with 80% of it immersed in the liquid. This happens, then 80% is inside the liquid. Fine. You need to find coefficient of expansion for the liquid. Assume that volume of solid remains constant between 20 and 100 degrees Celsius. Solid will not expand. Ignore that. Fine. You need to find gamma for liquid. how much? Did you get? No? See, what will happen is that whatever is the weight of the liquid, that should be equal to weight of the object only, because buoyant force is balancing mg. Get my point? So if this is the solid, let's say this is the solid, if total volume is V, then 3 by 4 times V is inside the liquid. So buoyant force will be what? Density of liquid into volume displaced, which is 3 by 4 V into G. Right? This is the buoyant force. Any doubt here? So this buoyant force is acting upwards. Okay? And then there will be a gravity force, let's say, which is mg, acting downwards. Okay? So initially, rho times, this is initial density of the liquid, rho naught 3 by 4 V into G, this is equal to mg. Any doubt here? No? This is the first equation. Alright? Now, after you heat it, density of liquid will change. Fine. Let's say new density is rho. So rho into, now 80% is inside the liquid. So 80 by 100, that is 8 by 10 times V into G, this should be equal to mg. Any doubts? Anything? Now this V remains V only. Repeating it. This volume is what? Volume of the solid, which doesn't expand. We are ignoring the expansion of solid. So it remains V. So just divide these two equations. Okay. You will get rho naught into 3 by 4 divided by rho into 4 by 5 is equal to 1. Fine. So from here you will get rho is equal to, or rho into 4 by 5 to be equal to rho naught into 3 by 4. Okay, so rho will be equal to rho naught into 15 by 16. Okay, any doubts? Nothing? So, how will you get gamma from here? This should be equal to what?
Rho naught.
Rho naught. 1 minus gamma delta t. What is delta t? 80. 100 from 20, right? This is 80. Rho naught and rho naught get cancelled. So 80 times gamma is equal to 1 minus 15 by 16. So gamma is 1 by 80 times 1 by 16. Did you get this? Kind of. Did you follow this concept like this? Right, so this is how you have to do this particular question. Okay.
So after giving the answer,
this is what? 18 to 16? 1180, which is 8.47 into 10 to the minus 4. 1 divided by this.